What up, bitches? It's the misanthropic one, aka He Who Hungers, and I'm back up in this bitch for another rant slash review. Today, I want to talk about two albums, both from the South, from the Atlanta area, or ATL, as people call it down there. I want to talk about T.I.'s new album called Trouble Man, Heavy is the Head, and Big Boy's latest album called Vicious Lies and Dangerous Rumors. So this is a double review. First off, Merry Christmas to all my fans and subscribers out there. And hope you have a happy new year, in case I don't make another video prior to then. But look out for my top 25 of 2012. That should at least be coming before the end of the year. But if not, look for the within the first week of January, if it doesn't come out this year. But first, I want to talk about T.I.'s latest album, Trouble Man, Heavy is the Head. Y'all already know who T.I. is. He's been around for a while now, probably close to a decade, if not more. I don't even remember, but yeah, I think it is over a decade. But yeah, this album, y'all know me, I like to buy the special bonus edition, limited editions of shit. This album, the bonus edition, or special edition, excuse me, comes with three bonus tracks at the end of it. And yeah, definitely love the artwork on this bitch. It looks like a almost like a old Western poster on there, where T.I. is holding a gun and it has like different images within the gun, like cars, bitches. It has a money sign on the actually where you put the magazine to the gun. It's actually a money sign under there. So I love the artwork. That's like some vintage Western movie shit. So definitely appreciate the artwork on that shit. Let's get into the producers and features. So let's get into some of these producers that are on this bitch. You have K Trax, you got Tommy Brown, Travis Sales, you have, there's so many on here that are written small. You have Cardiac, you have Chinky P, DJ Toomp, who T.I. collaborates with on previous efforts. He collaborates with him a lot. You got No ID, the legendary No ID. You have Rico Love and Earl and E. You have Jazzy Faye. On this bitch, DJ Monte, T Minus, he's on here a few times. I said T Minus already. Let's keep going. You have Lamar Mars Edwards, Lawrence Dobson, Little C. You have Pharrell from the Neptunes. Mentioned DJ Toomp already. Sanchez, Rock City, and they don't go into who produces the bonus tracks on this bitch. Actually, no, they do. I'm sorry. They're on the back of the CD insert right here, because it's two CDs that three extra songs on here. So let's see who produces on that bitch. T Tommy Brown and Travis Sales. Does it say on Parlay who produced that? And does it say who produced the third bonus track? Alright, fuck it. Whatever. But those are the producers on this bitch. Features on this album. You have Meek Mill, ASAP Rocky, Lil Wayne, R. Kelly, Pink, CeeLo Green, and I know I missed one. Yeah, Andre 3000. Production on here, you got typical T.I. production, but you know, a lot of people say it's reminiscent of trap music, and I agree. It has that old sound. A lot of the beats go hard, but it has a southern feel to it that you're used to when you listen to T.I. shit. Features on here, they do their thing. No one's fucking overwhelming. People like Akon and Pink do real well with the hooks. I really love the hooks that they contribute on this album. So, for the most part, no complaints with the features on this bitch. Okay, now's the part where I get into some of the tracks. I don't want to stay on this too long because I don't want to make this too long of a fucking video because I tend to ramble. Alright, so the album starts strong with the introduction, G-Season, all that shit. I'm going to go into some of my favorite tracks on this bitch though. Let's see. Yeah, it starts strong with like the first four tracks, and then by the time it gets over to track five, which is Ball featuring Lil Wayne, I think that song kind of like puts a halt on the launch of this album, because that song is like, it just kills the vibe for me. It's just like a club song. It, you know, it started off hard, started off on some southern G shit, and you just get to that, and it's just like, it kind of reminds me of on Nas's album Life Is Good, where when the album was taking off so fucking well, and then Summer's on Smash came, and it just was like, what the fuck, this doesn't even fit. So that's what that kind of was, a big fucking roadblock for me. But the album picks back up with Sorry featuring Andre 3000. Songs like Can You Learn featuring R. Kelly. Guns N' Roses featuring Pink, where T.I. is speaking on relationship shit, the trials and tribulations, dealing with fucking relationships. The Way We Ride is a track about joyriding and various shit that T.I. is doing while riding. Cruising, to me, that track is kind of weak, but it's similar to The Way We Ride. It comes right after it, so it kind of has a transitional feel content-wise. The only reason I really don't like that track is because it reminds me of that one track off of Paper Trail, Whatever You Like. That song is just, to me, it's him, you know, singing, doing that light shit. I like T.I. to just go in over a beat, you know what I mean, like he usually does. And that just slowed down the album for me. I'm gonna go ahead to Addresses, which is it's a diss track, and I love it. Dope beat. T.I. again is going in, going hard, and you know, it's a dope track. But the one thing that bothers me about it is he's not saying who it's about. And in interviews, he was being asked, you know, who are you addressing, and he's being cryptic about who the fuck he's addressing. So that kind of annoys me, but it's eventually gonna come out. If anybody has any idea who the fuck he's talking about, post it down there. Those rumors that it was Gucci Mane and or God, I forget who the other person was. But I don't know, whatever. Wonderful Life, one of my favorite tracks on here, featuring Akon. He's talking to his folks about how his life turned out so far with the drug dealing and him not graduating college, I believe, or school, or some sort of either high school or college, I forget right now. But dope storyteller on that track. And Hallelujah is the last track, if you got the regular version. And I could imagine if you got the regular version, it's a dope way to end the track, the CD. But you got the three extra tracks on here. And if you do have the three extra tracks, there's extra features on here. You have Dope, D-O-P-E, and you have Trader Truth. Yeah, so that's it for this album. I thought it was a fucking great album by T.I. I'll rate it after I talk about the next album. Next album I want to talk about, I already mentioned it, Vicious Lies, Dangerous Rumors by Big Boy. Y'all know him, one half of Outkast, dope MC, legendary MC, blah, 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 blah. One of my favorites from Atlanta as well. Let me get into some of the producers on this bitch. You have Cy Fife, Mr. DJ, Fantogram. Let's see who else is producing on this shit. Showdown, DJ Aries, and Black Owned. Sharif Wilson. Chris Carmouche and Jaron Ward. Yeah, I mentioned Chris Carmouche just now. The Flush. Big Boy does some co-producing on here, by the way. Organized Noise. John Hill. Arthur MacArthur. Okay. Andy Andromedon Slagle. Gary Fly. J. Paul. Where are you? Yeah, Organized Noise I mentioned, and Chris Carmouche I mentioned, okay. And let's get into the features real quick. You got Sleepy Brown, who Outkast has collaborated with before. Fantagram, who's on here a few times. T.I., Ludacris, Kid Cudi, Lil Dragon, Killer Mike, Kelly Rowland from Destiny's Child, A$AP Rocky, B.O.B., Waves, Moosh, Scar, Bosco, Jai Paul, UGK, Big Crit, Theophilus London, and Trey Loose. Okay, sound-wise, this album, it picks up right where Big Boy's last album left off at. You know, you have those weird, abstract beats that still have a southern feel. This one has less of a southern feel to it than Sir Luscious Left Foot, but it's still dope anyway, because Outkast has always been somewhat semi-experimental, you know, in their later years. So this isn't too far of a stretch for Big Boy. And if you like his last album, you have to love this album. You just have to. Features, there's a shitload of features on here. You know, it's kind of a turn off. Y'all know how I feel about that. but most of them are doing hooks or singing or whatever, so it's not too bad. Big Boy's doing most of the rapping, with the exception of, you know, T.I. and Ludacris, who come on there, and let me tell you, that's one of my favorite posse cuts this year. That song In the A that they all went in on, love that fucking track. As far as the content on this album, I'm still trying to decipher some of the songs, but most of them have to do with relationship shit and dealing with women, as far as I could decipher so far. I know the lyrics are in here, but I haven't really fully gone through the lyrics. I just, you know, been busy, basically. But let me tell you, I really love this album. I listened to it about 3 times in full, and I'm still trying to decipher it. It gives me mad replay value, yeah, shit is ill. Pick it up. Actually, funny story, real quick. See, this is me rambling. I bought the regular version because I did not think that there was a special version. And a week later, I went back to Best Buy and I saw that they put the special fucking version out. And whatever. But I like to rate these albums on the same scale. I'll give them both in between. Well, no, actually, the T.I., I'm feeling in between a 7 and 8. And this one, I give like an 8 to 8.25. This one I like a little bit better because of Big Boy's ability to take risks. And T.I.'s was dope too, don't get me wrong, but I like this just a little bit more. And yeah, that's about it. Sorry if I talked your ear off, but I know a lot of motherfuckers wanted these reviews, especially the T.I. Mad motherfuckers were hitting me up for the T.I. So that's it. Everybody else, y'all know the deal. Leave your love, leave your hate. Most of all, subscribe. Support dope ass fucking music, alright? Peace, bitches.